The internet is full of bro science, fake knowledge, half information or propaganda. Your quest of reliable, authentic health information ends here. So subscribe this channel and hit the bell icon and you never have to go anywhere else ever again.
Hello everyone, how are you today? I'm Dr. Paramjeet and you're watching Dr. Education. Guys, we are going to talk about platelet counts today. We have already made videos about complete hemogram, WBCs, red blood cells, low, high, and we have explained the normal values as well. You can watch those videos in my channel. Just search for them with the name Dr. Education and you'll find the videos, right? They are both in English and Hindi. So today we are going to talk about platelet counts. What makes a platelet count low? What if your platelet counts are high? What will happen? Both of the things will be explaining today. So a higher than normal platelet count, because normal platelet count is 1.5 lakhs to 4.5 lakhs. That's the average. So if it is higher than that, then what is the most probable chances? See, high platelet count may be because of bleeding. A chronic bleeding can actually lead to increased production of platelets in your body. Then that can lead to high platelet count. Then diseases such as cancers can also lead to increased production of platelets. Iron deficiency can lead to lower platelet counts. Remember, iron deficiency can lead to higher platelet counts. So iron deficiency will lead to lower hemoglobin levels. They will have low RBCs or hemoglobin levels low, but platelet counts will increase. Or any problem which is there in the bone marrow, you can have a high platelet count. Remember this, right? Except bone marrow suppression. If there is an infection or tumor in the bone marrow, your platelet counts are increased. Okay? So that is one reason. So when will we have a low platelet count? A low platelet count will have when your platelets are getting destroyed, right? Disorders, there are many disorders where your platelets are getting destroyed. Like if you are taking antiplatelet medications, right? If you are having any DICs, right? Disseminated intravascular coagulation, or any kind of where internal coagulations or internal clots are forming and your platelets are getting used up or destroyed. Then pregnancy is a condition where you will have low platelet count. Then infections like dengue fever, chikungunya, viruses are there, which can actually lead to low platelet count, right? Then if you have all these things, abnormal and broken down platelets, they will all go into the spleen and your spleen will get enlarged. So your spleen can get enlarged in this kind of condition, in these disorders. So that is also one sign which is found with low platelet count. Then obviously bone marrow failure. Now that's a different thing. If you have a bone marrow failure, you may even have a low or high platelet count, depending upon. So failure will have a low platelet count. Infections, tumors can have high platelet count. But after a while, a tumor or infection can actually damage the bone marrow and then it can lead to lower platelet count. Right? And radiation therapy, bone marrow fibrosis or cancer chemotherapies can lead to low platelet counts. So all these reasons are there for low platelet counts, and we have to manage the patient depending upon the condition and the most likely reason, along with other results of CBC.